I think we got everyone's order pretty much taken. We got this is such a great turnout for Carlos Cuadras's media lunch. We actually had to add extra space here, so we appreciate everyone coming. We appreciate everyone that's involved with this fight. The WBC is here. Pepe Suleiman is representing the WBC. Nancy Rodriguez, Tony Walker from HBO is sitting next to me. HBO is distributing the pay-per-view broadcast, and without their help, this event wouldn't be taking place. Rudy Hernandez is a trainer. Carlos Cuadras, everyone knows Rudy and his family locally here in LA, and then naturally Carlos Cuadras, former WBC super flyweight champion. He'll be training here in LA with Rudy, and you know, it's just exciting to put, once we announced the Chocotito fight against Rungvisai, it was exciting to put Carlos Cuadras on the pay-per-view show because of the great performance he had, even though he lost the decision to Chocotito. Everyone, I like to say, he stole the show at the Forum on HBO. It really was his coming out party. You know, he'd been a champion, but a lot of people didn't know who Carlos was. And with the announcement, we had a lot of excited people to see him back in the ring because of his exciting style, his great personality. He'll be fighting David Carmona, also from Mexico City. So that's a great matchup. And the WBC, Pepe might be able to go into a little more detail. The WBC just mandated that Carlos Cuadras, if he wins, then he'll be in the mandatory position. So the winner of Chocotito versus Rungvisai will have to fight Carlos Cuadras in the next fight. And so HBO would be excited about putting Carlos back on the air. And as the third fight of this pay-per-view, it's exciting. I also wanted, since you all came here, I want to make the announcement also of the fourth fight. A lot of people have been asking who will be the first opening bout. It'll be Ryan Martin against Bryant Pee-wee Cruz. Bryant Cruz is local in New York. Ryan Martin is the current WBC Continental Americas champion, so he'll be defending his title. And Ryan Martin's undefeated at 17-0. Pee-wee Cruz is 17-1, so it's a great matchup between two exciting lightweights, young, exciting guys that will be a great way to open the broadcast. With that, Pepe, did you want to say a few words on behalf of the WBC? And we have the WBC has actually two world championship fights, naturally Triple G versus Jacobs, and also the Chocotito fight. So on behalf of WBC, Pepe Suleiman.
I'm going to come here in front.
Come up here, yeah.
Can see us. Yes, I had a communication with Mauricio, my brother, president of the WBC, saying that if Carlos wins the fight, which I'm sure he will be the one who the match of the winner of Chocolatito and Rungvisai will be Carlos Cuadras. And I'm very sure that will happen. Carlos, I remember Carlos when he was at the, I met Carlos when he was just a little kid. He was just a little blondie kid in the gym of José Luis Bueno. And from the first moment, there was a very important spark in him. The first fight, professional fight that I saw him, it was, you can, whenever Carlos was in the ring, you can say that there's a boxer. He got knocked down in the first round, he got up and knocked the other guy out immediately. So he has so, besides the charisma and everything that characterizes him, he's such a splendid fighter. He can box, he can roll, so he's one of our very, very favorite champions, very good close friend, personal friend, also the WBC, and I'm really, really looking forward to that rematch. If he goes against Rungvisai, he used to have a different name before, that was a very tough fight for Carlos, he won the title with him, and to have a rematch between those, it will be a war like No, none other. So that is official, and that's for the moment. It's all that I have to. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pepe.
Thank you.
That's what a lot of people don't realize is that both Chocotito and Room of Aside before. So whoever is the winner, it would be a rematch from one of his previous opponents. So that'll be exciting. You know, we just want to acknowledge Madison Square Garden and the role that they've played in hosting this great event. The last time Triple G fought at the Garden was against David Lemieux when he unified the title versus the IBF champion. And that was completely sold out. Right now, the ticket sales are ahead of where the Lemieux fight was, so we're expecting a sellout. We're expecting a tremendous weekend in New York, great energy in the arena. Top Rank is doing a St. Patrick's Day show on the Friday before, featuring Michael Conlon. The Boxing Writers Dinner is on the Thursday, so it's gonna be a great weekend in New York City, and especially Saturday night at a sold-out Madison Square Garden, live on HBO pay-per-view. You know, Triple G started his career on HBO September 2012. Without the HBO platform, he wouldn't be nearly where he is today or as marketable as he's become. Naturally, he put on the exciting fights in the ring, but somebody had to broadcast them, and we have a terrific partner in HBO. So with that, I'd like to introduce Tony Walker to say a few words about the show.
Yeah, thanks, Tom. Hello, everybody. Great to be here. Yes, we've been with Triple G since he came to the U.S., and it has been a great ride for us. Probably, you know, obviously one of the best pound-for-pound fighters in the world, a great personality, someone easy to sell. And whenever we do the pay-per-view shows, of course, we want to give a great night of boxing. We realize people have a lot of things they can spend $55 or $65 on. So giving them a good night of entertainment that they can enjoy with their friends and family is important. Triple G has been so dominant, his fights haven't ended, you know, haven't taken very long, you know, to happen. So having Carlos and Chocolatito on the cards really, I think, enhances the card and makes it appeal to a wider audience than what it would happen otherwise. We always try to do good undercards, but it's not often you get this level of fights on the undercard. World-class guys vying for titles where the fights mean so much to them, and we'd like to welcome Carlos to the card and to HBO pay-per-view, and it's going to be a great night. All our distributors are very excited about the show and the undercard that they say does make a difference with people buying. So it's going to be a good night for us. And thanks to K2 and Tom for putting all this together. I know it's not easy. These guys have built their careers and demand, you know, good paychecks. Mm-hmm. And we know that they're going to put on a good show, and I think it will be returned.
Thank you, Tony. It's you know, I have to also acknowledge Peter Nelson for having the foresight of putting on not only Triple G, but putting on Chocotito, you know, with the smaller divisions. These guys in the 112, 115-pound divisions, they put on some of the most exciting fights. And just because they're smaller in division or smaller in stature doesn't mean that they shouldn't be have the exposure, especially here in the United States or internationally. So Peter saw the foresight of putting on a middleweight champion from Kazakhstan who didn't speak much English. He saw that he had the foresight of putting on Chocolatito, who never really was featured on you know, prime television in the United States. He had the foresight of putting on Usyk, who was the cruiserweight champion. It was the first time, I think, in over 10 years, 15 years maybe, that HBO had shown a cruiserweight championship, and also featuring Carlos Cuadras from Mexico. So it's we really give him a lot of credit. And naturally, you know, if you want to be a star in the sport, the fighters, you know, it's only so much where we can make the fights, HBO can broadcast the fights, and then, you know, the fans can buy tickets, but the fighters have to perform in the ring. And the fight last year between Carlos Cuadras and Chocolatito Gonzalez was one of the fights of the year. It won, in fact, the WBC Fight of the Year. And, you know, it's just, it was a tremendous event. And again, that's where the personality of Carlos showed through, and an important part of his team. I want to acknowledge Nobu, who's here from Taikin Promotions. Mr. Honda of Taikin is Carlos's promoter, so we definitely want to acknowledge Mr. Honda and his role in allowing us to put these fights together. And this isn't, you know, a lot of people aren't talking about David Carmona, but it's not like, you know, it's an easy fight just to stay active until he gets a shot at the title again. David Carmona is also from Mexico City, has a great record, and is going to come to try to beat Carlos. So it's going to be a great matchup, and I'd like to introduce, as I mentioned, an important part of Carlos's team is Rudy Hernandez, who will be training Carlos to get ready for the fight. You want to say a few words, Rudy, about...
Yeah, make sure you guys buy the pay-per-view. It's going to be a great card. Really appreciate your sponsorships as well. So don't miss this great card. I mean, fireworks. March 18th, Madison Square Garden. So be there.
We have Tecate as a title sponsor, so you'll be able to indulge after the fight.
You get a 12-pack.
I just want a 6. It'll make my wife happy. She won't look at other guys anymore.
So then, Carlos, if you want to say a few words, and then Rudy, will you be you'll be translating?
He speaks English.
Yeah. I understand. Don't worry.
Good. Okay.
My Carlos. English is very, very bad. I talk in bad, so
but
I understand.
But you look
understand.
Very, very good, so it's good.
Very, very handsome. I speak more Japanese. Oh, estamos haciendo un buen trabajo siempre con Rudy. Siempre me enseña nuevas cosas. Puedo aprender nuevos pasos, así que eso los puedo aventar ahora por la otra pelea.
Okay,
so y pues...
No, in English.
In English?
See what I'll do in English.
For the next fight, you watch my newest tips for boxing.
Huh? New tricks.
My new tricks in boxing.
Okay, eso. Y pues, espero que también Chocolate le gane a Rubizar porque la tiene difícil y yo me quiero enfrentar a él otra vez. Tengo que pasar primero a Carmona. Hacer una buena pelea, yo creo que me tengo que lucir con un buen knockout para que la gente pida más esa pelea con Chocolate. Y pues espero que si gana no le dé miedo.
He says that he hopes that both him and Gonzalez win so that they can have the rematch. Pretty much that's what he's saying. Go.
Yeah.
You know?
Sure. Y pues que estén pendientes ahora de esta pelea. En el Madison, estoy contento en el Madison. Así que, pues esperen buenas cosas porque voy a dar una gran pelea este 18 y espero que no se raje el chocolate. Es todo.
¿Ah, tú sí?
He says, he'll be ready. He just hopes that that Gonzalez, if they're both to win, that he doesn't back out of this fight. It sounds a little nicer in English, but when you say que no se raje, that's like, damn. Yeah. So, but
he have a scar.
He's scared.
He's scared.
Yeah. I don't think he's scared. I think he respects him a little bit more. Digo, no tiene mucho miedo, pero yo creo que te respeta un poquito más.
Yo creo que sí. Los ojitos de chinito, yo creo que lo va a recordar.
This will be Carlos's first fight in Madison Square Garden, you know, where so many boxers dream of fighting, all the history at the Mecca of boxing. So we're excited to bring Carlos's talents and his excitement to the East Coast, to New York City, and to Madison Square Garden. We can probably open it up at this point to questions. Lance, you want to ask a question?
Carlos, when I saw you at the WBC convention in December, it seemed at that point like you thought that the fight with Gonzalez was going to happen, that maybe you guys were just haggling through some money. At the end of the day, do you think that he is sort of like not ducking you, but maybe dodging you to take on this mandatory fight instead of jumping back into what was a very tough fight?
Dice que cuando te dieron, cuando suben en la convención, y tú estabas más o menos con la idea de que ibas a pelear con el chocolatito. Ahora, de repente cambia la cosa. Tú crees que está, no es tanto que se esté bajando, pero que esté buscando sacarle provecho.
Bueno, pues.
¿Cómo vas al cinturón?
Yo creo que sí, ¿no? Que el chocolate le quiso sacar brillo a su cinturón de una pelea más.
Porque you figured that he could get another payday out of the belt first, then he'd have to fight him.
Porque sabe que en la otra lo va a noquear.
Because he believes that Gonzalez realizes that in the rematch he can't win. He's going to knock him out.
It seemed as if in the second half of the fight you were coming on. Do you think that that's what's in his mind, the way you were fighting for the second half of the fight and the way he looked at the end of the fight?
Dice que todo parece indicar que después en la segunda mitad de la pelea ya ves escalado y empezas a imponer tu ritmo y tu golpe. Entonces sí, se notó que después de la pelea ya estaba bien marcado. ¿Qué es lo que tiene en mente?
Pues,
que es el recuerdo más que le queda.
Pues sí, porque ya no le duele, ya no le queda el recuerdo. Pero yo pienso que él sabe que la próxima pelea va al round 13 y que va a empezar desde el principio la guerra.
He says that he thinks that Gonzalez understands that the next time they meet, it'll be round 13 and he'll pick up where he left off.
Carlos, you and Chuck Liddell had such a great fight last September, and now you're both fighting on the same card, and obviously, of course, you're fighting David Carmona, but people are talking about that Chuck Liddell rematch because it was such a great fight. Now the WBC has mandated the two winners, March 18th, fight each other. How do you stay focused and not look past David Carmona for this fight?
De este de Carmona y no ver más allá.
Bueno, pues es paso a paso.
Es step by step. Mm-hmm.
Es paso a paso y pues ahorita el siguiente paso es Carmona y pues hay que trabajar para ganarle a Carmona.
Well, the next step is Carmona and he's got to work to beat Carmona.
Y pues después lo que ve.
And then after that, whatever comes next.
Rudy, can you ask them, since they're both from Mexico City, is there any rivalry, since they're both the same division,
between Carmona? ¿Hay rivalidad entre tú y Carmona, siendo que son de México los dos?
Pues no, solamente lo he visto pelear un par de veces, pero...
He's only seen him fight a couple of times.
Lo conozco, es de la ciudad, lo he visto en varios eventos.
He's met him before, he's seen him in a couple of events, and also at our training camp when we were out there.
Pero pues en realidad no... No lo conozco mucho, no hay rivalidad, pero...
There's no rivalry between them.
Pero deje que venga y le eche un poquito de chile.
We can make a rivalry.
Go make it happen.
Yeah, he'll make it happen. Algo le de ya.
Sí.
Carlos, I'm interested to know what the reaction was from the fans back home in Mexico when you returned home. From the Chocolatito.
¿Cómo fue la reacción de la gente en México cuando volviste después de la pelea?
Oh, pues, en el aeropuerto me recibieron mucha gente muy bien. No sé, yo me sorprendí, me recibieron como si yo hubiera ganado. Y...
Because when he came back to Mexico, when he was at the airport, there was a lot of people there at the airport waiting for him, and he was really surprised. He felt like he had won the. You know, he, upon his arrival, he felt like he had been the winner because everyone was there to see him, greet him.
Is he over the loss? Did it take a while for him to get over it, if he is?
¿La derrota quedó en el pasado o todavía la siguiente?
No, pues tengo la espinita.
You still hurt a little, but...
Ahí clavada, así que la tengo que sacar.
I think I can answer that better than him before. yo creo que yo lo puedo contestar eso mejor que tú.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Carlos lives the moment. Like it's like the next 30, 40 seconds, whatever it is, he just is that moment, right? Once it's over, you know, it bothers him. It's still there. It's not going to go away, right? But it's like he's thinking about what's next. Not so much about what happened yesterday is already happened. He's not looking at that. He's moving on.
Yeah, pues ya pasó.
Yeah, he just don't. he cares on getting it back. That's it.
As his trainer, what did you say to him after the fight? Since the fight was so close, how did you
in the ring? In the ring, it was as soon as they announced him the winner, I told him, "Let's go." And he says, "Yeah, I got robbed." I go, "No, you didn't. You didn't get robbed. It was just a close decision. It could have gone either way. This leave with this lip." We walked out, and there was no reason to be up in that ring anymore. And I felt it was, you know, it's like, it's just a matter of opinions. Like Tom said earlier, you know, we lost, you know, and it's, I almost say that, well, it's just a matter of opinions, because at the end of the day, it's like if you get like six people, you know, you get two and two, you know, two in favor, two against, and two a draw. So it was that close of a fight, and I think it could have gone either way. I personally thought it was a draw, but at the end of the day, it's like we move on and we'll make it right the next time. And I told him, if you fight him again, you have to knock him out. He goes, I told him, I don't care if you win 11 out of 12 rounds and they announce a decision that you won, you get that belt and you take it back to him and give it back to him because you don't deserve it. You have to knock him out. And he goes, yeah, but if I win 11 rounds out of 12, I should be champion. I go, no, it doesn't count because you didn't knock him out. And the bottom line is that you have to knock him out. And I really believe that he has everything to make that happen.
Usually trainers aren't as honest as you just put it to your fighter. Talk to me a little bit about that, because you hear a lot of trainers that would just go, no, you won. Or would it be that upfront or honest with your fighter?
Once a decision has been rendered, I mean, how many times have you heard them go back and, you know, announce that, well, there was a mistake? I know sometimes, you know, the scorecards or somebody tested positive for something, you know, but on fights like this, man, it's like, they could have gone either way. It's like, and just be honest, you know, you can't, like you say, you can't cry over spilled milk, right? I mean, it is what it is. Now we move on.
Rudy, have you guys watched that fight with Chocolatito and looked over the footage and seen anything in there that you can learn from, seen any nuances that you could take advantage of in the rematch going forward?
It's for him it's going to be more about confidence. He's confident enough to know that he's there, right there with him, and if not, but he has to prove that point by knocking him out in the rematch. That's why it's important that he believes, and by him stating that round 13 comes up, he's already on that mode, and so I like that, our chances.
Gotcha. Yeah. Thank you.
How does your honesty? Well, I guess the question would be to Carlos, but how does your honesty as a trainer help him be a better fighter?
Well, he knows I'm not full of crap. Or I'm bullshitting him, you know.
Some, as Mark was saying, some are not as honest as you, but help him get over that loss that he had.
I'm not a yes man. Bottom line, that's what it comes down to. I'm brutally honest as I see fit. You know, I mean, we may have a difference of opinions, but at the end of the day, it's like he knows what he gets. You know, at the end, of, you know, it's if I'm honest with him and he feels it, man, and it's sincere, then. You know, we can have this discussion or conversation, you know, but if he's looking for somebody who just rub his back and say, yeah, what a nice guy, you know, like, I don't help him that. I can't help him. Me personally can't help him. There's a bunch of other trainers out there that I don't care how high, you know, the level that they are in, they tend to cater to the fighters. I'm not that guy. There's a purpose. When the bell rings and the guy's trying to knock your head off, it ain't funny. It's not a joke either. You know, it's, and so I take this very seriously.
Carlos, how do you take to him being really honest with you about how he felt he saw the fight that night?
Dice que él quiere saber cómo tú te sientes cuando yo te hablo y pues que ya ves que yo te hablo honestamente como lo siento, ¿cómo te sientes tú?
Oh, sí, yo siento que Rudy siempre es como bien honesto conmigo. Aunque haya trabajado con el chocolate, yo creo que volteé la bandera, pero yo siempre he confiado en él y creo que hemos trabajado bien desde que empecé a trabajar.
Okay, so he says since we've been working together, he likes my honesty, and he appreciates it because at the end of the day, it's you know, he's comfortable with it.
On the mandatory, Carlos, do you think that for sure Roman will now adhere to that, and if he wins and you win, that he will take that fight? And Tom, same question for you.
Dice que sí, bueno, ahora que sí, si gana Gonzalo, si ganas tú, entonces ya la revancha ya se, ¿tú crees que el Chocolatito va a pelear contigo?
Pues yo espero que sí, yo espero, es lo que más quiero.
He hopes that that's what happens, because that's what he wants the most.
Convéncelo.
He says convince him, he's like, hey, convince him, he's telling Tom, convince Gonzalez to fight him.
I think Lance, to answer your question, I mean, really, you have to ask Chocolatito about that, but from my understanding was Chocolatito.
Why do we have to ask him?
Well,
why can't we tell him?
But he inherited the obligation that Carlos had as a mandatory for Rung Vasai, and you know, everything that I'm hearing about Rung Vasai, he's a big puncher, and I think Carlos even said it, that it's not an easy fight for Chocolatito. So it's not like he chose an easier fight instead of Cuadras. My feeling is that you know, he had the option of either doing, he had to do the mandatory, and his only other option would have been to do the rematch with Carlos. That's what the WBC had ordered. So I believe he wanted to make the rematch bigger, fight Rung Vasai, and then it would make it bigger with Carlos being on the same show. I think that's how it worked out. But you know, I think with Chocolatito having won four titles in four different divisions, being undefeated at 46-0, you know, it's hard to question his character or his courage. And I think he'd be looking forward to, if he's successful in March, you know, to defending the title.
Okay, thank you.
Power field. ¿Cómo sentías? ¿Dices un poder de chocolate? Pues fíjate que no tiene esa pegada tan fulminante como en peso mini mosca, a lo mejor pegaba más duro. Tiene una pegada respetable porque pues tampoco son caricias, ¿verdad? Pero sí, yo siento que no tiene la pegada tan fuerte como la tiene Rubisai. Rubisai, yo siento que pega más duro y por eso es peligroso para el Chocolate. Tiene menos defensa y es más lento, pero yo espero que gane el Chocolate. Yo quiero que gane el Chocolate porque Rubisai no siento que sea una pelea tan atractiva para la gente aquí en Estados Unidos. A Chocolate ya lo conocen más. Esta pelea me va a dar a conocer un poco más aquí en Estados Unidos, en HBO, y pues yo espero que sí gane y que ya no ande dando la vuelta otra vez.
¿Cómo te sientes que ya estás de nuevo de regreso aquí con HBO y que estás aquí con la prensa en los Estados Unidos?
Bueno, pues la última pelea también fue aquí, ahora me siento un poquito más pues más desenvuelto, que ya conozco más a la gente me conoce un poquito más y creo que eso también es bueno para que pues suba el rating, ¿no? Que la gente nos pueda conocer y podamos pues tener mejores bolsas y mejores oportunidades después.
Carlos, muchos consideran a Chocolatito que sea el número uno libra por libra. ¿Tú estás de acuerdo con eso o ves a alguien más que sea el número uno? I just asked him if he agrees that Chocolatito is number one pound for pound.
No, pues yo creo que sí, Chocolatito sí es el mejor libra por libra, pues a mí me pone en una posición mucho mejor, ¿no? Yo creo que puedo darle pelea a cualquiera, ¿no? Y pues si le di pelea al mejor libra por libra, pues creo que le puedo dar a cualquiera.
Carlos, ¿cómo te sientes debutar en un pago por evento? Es una gran vitrina para tu carrera.
Bueno, pues dice que hay un bonus por el pay-per-view, entonces. Sí. No. Entonces, pues, a todo dar.
The rhythm was worth it. The one I already had those, but on this one was, you know, Did you ask him how does it feel to be, you know, pro, you know, for him to debut in on a pay debut card? And then he was asking, how does he feel like Gonzalez? A lot of people rank him as like the number one pound for pound. And he felt like he deserves that spot.
Carlos, what do you think about becoming more famous in the United States? A year ago, not many people knew you in the U.S., and now you're fighting on pay-per-view at Madison Square Garden. Was that your goal always in your career to become known all over the world?
Ha sido, bueno, ahora que pasa es que volver a pelear en Estados Unidos, ¿te imaginabas si algún día ser bien reconocido mundialmente?
Oh, pues,
que Estados Unidos.
Bueno, pues ese es el sueño de todo peleador, que lo conozcan en todo el mundo, ser campeón del mundo y...
It's every fighter's dream to be known worldwide.
Sí, pues yo creo que estamos ahí haciendo caminito por ahí.
He's on his way.
He saw Chocolatito in Florida at the WBC convention. You asked him if he had any sort of interaction with him, and if he asked him directly.
Viste a Chocolatito ya en Florida, y ¿hablaste con él, lo platicaste con él?
No, pues, muy poco. Ya ve que no hablo mucho de chocolate. Y, solamente los momentos que pudimos platicar. Fue así de, hey, pues, la gente quiere esa pelea, hay que hacerla. Y solamente fue un, sí, vamos a ver lo que dice el señor Honda. Bueno, ok.
You understood that, right? So,
well,
that's
right.
He said that the few times that he did see Gonzalez, it was pretty much like, hey, you know, people want to see that fight again. He goes, well, you know, well, yeah, you know, we'll see what Mr. Honda says, and you know, we'll just take it from there. And then he goes and asked him if he had spoken to him or if they had talked. And he said, well, you know, Gonzalez doesn't talk much, so you know, he couldn't get much out of him.
Just going back to the overall show, as a recap, you know, when you have an undefeated fighter like Triple G, what he's accomplished in the main event, defending, you know, this is a WBA mandatory fight against Danny Jacobs, who's himself one of the biggest knockout punchers in the sport. You have Chocolatito Gonzalez versus Rungvisai. This is probably the highest profile fight for a Thai fighter, a fighter out, from Thailand, in a long time, you know, challenging the number one pound for pound fighter for the WBC 115 pound championship at Madison Square Garden on HBO pay-per-view. It's got a little bit of something for everyone. You know, Chocolatito from Nicaragua, you know, recognized as the number one pound for pound. You have Carlos against Carmona. You have Ryan Martin from Chattanooga, Tennessee, training in Cleveland against Pee Wee Cruz. So it's really a special card that we tried to put together that provides something for everyone, provides a lot of entertainment. All the matchups, not just the names, all the matchups are great matchups. And really the only local fighters are Danny Jacobs and Pee Wee Cruz that live in the New York area. And so it's really going to have a great international flavor, as most of Triple G shows do. So we're glad to have had this media conference. I think after everyone is finished eating, we can go into some one-on-one interviews with anyone sitting up here. If anyone has any other questions, we can answer them through the lunch.
Just a quick update on what you've heard from Abel on how Golovkin's training is going up quickly.
Says he's training in snowshoes up there. He's running in the snow. There's a great photo that Abel took where the snow has just covered all the trees and snowing, and you just see him, you know, in his jacket running down the middle of the road. I was up there last week before the show in Indio. And Abel says it's the most snow he's ever seen in Big Bear. But, you know, that's what champions are made of. You know, they'll train in any conditions, and Gennady just feels comfortable up there regardless of the climate or the temperature. And
that's like his backyard.
He pushes
even at home.
Everyone else that's training up there, he's pushing them as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
The remainder of his camp's going to be here, right? Padres?
Huh?
The remainder of his camp's going to be here?
Yes.
Yeah. So he's already done with the mountains. So
aquí vas a entrar, ¿no?
Aquí no, en Maywood.
En Maywood.
Aquí no costales ni rindo.
I can also announce a few of the events coming up on the schedule leading up to the fight. Is Danny Jacobs is going to have an open workout at his gym, at Virgil Hunter's gym up in Oakland. That'll be February 13th. That's a Monday, February 13th. We'll have a media day here in LA where Triple G is going to come down with Abel. Rudy's going to be there with Carlos. That's scheduled right now for February 28th. That's a Tuesday, and it should be in the Wildcard West gym where we've had those open workouts for Gennady before. And then Fight Week's going to start early. We're going to have the main event press conference on Monday with Triple G and Jacobs. Then we're going to have the media training on Tuesday with all the championship fighters. For the media training, and then the undercard press conference will be on Wednesday. So it'll be an early start to the fight week, just to get out and get the media attention starting. We have named the card Middleweight Madness in lieu of the NCAA tournament, you know, March Madness that's going on. And naturally, as I mentioned before, St. Patrick's Day weekend in New York will be a tremendous, tremendous weekend. So we appreciate all your support. The great thing about this show is just not only the fighters in great matchups, but the fighters actually willing to go and promote the fight. Because one thing to put on great fights, but if nobody sees them, it's a completely different story. So, you know, Triple G has always been great marketing. Danny Jacobs has been fabulous with giving interviews, social media. You see Carlos here is taking time out from his training. They actually had sparring set up for today to do this. This event, and it's one of those things where everyone is on board marketing this fight, and I think it'll be whoever buys the pay-per-view, whoever buys a ticket to MSG, will definitely get their money's worth on March 18th. So we can maybe turn off some of the cameras for now, so we can start eating. Like I said, we can do one-on-one interviews afterwards. We have.